Today on Typical Books, I'm going to be talking about the books that I've read recently and a couple books that I picked up at the huge library book sale in my town, and also how I'm using my phone as a camera. At least today. I don't know how that's going to keep going. I kind of like it, and I can use my actual good microphone, so I'm pretty excited. But hey, anyone in the know knows that I've recently read Small Town Horror by Ronald Malfi. This will be the next review I do, along with The Haunting of Velkwood by Gwendolyn Keist. I think the two books go together really, really well. And I'll still be reading some Small Town Horror, but I took a little break from it and started reading two very different books. But I absolutely love this. It's on a lot of people's lists. If you've been hemming and hawing about this, definitely pick it up. What I need to do is pick up the You Like It Dark by Stephen King, because that's been on a lot of people's lists too. I'm a huge Stephen King fan, but this really had that same vibe. So if you have read some Stephen King lately, or getting into it by following Jason's Weird Reads and Sin's Book Nook. Sin and Jason have been talking about the Gunslinger trilogy, the Dark Tower series, Stephen King, and I absolutely love that. So I did pick up, you'll see something that links into that. But if you've been following them, getting into Stephen King, it's summertime, very much Stephen King weather, and you want more, but someone else, Ronald Malfi, if you haven't checked it out. And I'm going to have to be checking out another video I saw on BookTube about someone who read a whole bunch of Ronald Malfi books, and I believe that it was Anna Kent. But yes, highly, highly, highly recommended. A couple of books that I read right after I started a very light summary read, the Boris Karloff Horror Anthology, which is neat because on Dead Air Podcast, we were just talking about a Boris Karloff anthology that's quite different in film format, but this really caught my eye, and I'll be talking about it because I want to show off the amazing art inside, and it's not that easy to come by, I don't think, especially not in a hardcover, so I lucked out with the library copy. But yeah, really fun to revisit some of these. Really neat to rediscover very old authors that I should have already read. But yeah, this was a real find. And I just finished reading Notice by Heather Lewis this morning, and it is bleak and it is interestingly written. By the time I was feeling this book is about nothing, and I'm not feeling anything, I'm not feeling even interested in this, but I felt that I was waiting for something to happen for the longest time, and I really enjoyed the darkest moments of the book, which come near the very end. This would make a really interesting film, although some of the darkest parts that I enjoyed the most near the end aren't something that I'd really want to see on film, or most people shouldn't want to see on film. I've watched a lot of really bleak and dark, disturbing films in my time, and this would rank up there somewhere in the middle of the darkest and most bleak. I really did like the style, though, that's described on the back as a register of an emotional fugue state, and that is exactly what it is. It's not quite a stream of consciousness, but I think it's named Notice because it's the most commonly used word in the book. I wanted to get a sense of the author, though, because I'd never, of course, heard anything by Heather Lewis, and she's talked about as like the most masterful novelist of her time, even though she only wrote like three novels that I know of, and I had never heard of her. So I wanted to take a look, and there's only very few photos of her that are popularized on Google anyway, and one is this young dark-haired girl laying on a bed in black and white, and the light is just so stark, and there's nothing really in the room around her. And that's how I felt reading this, that there's nothing in these rooms around Nina while we're reading about her trials and tribulations, I guess, to use a cliched term, but like the world that she's created around her is extremely dark and bleak to the full extent of the word, where that there's nothing really around her but this morose sense of nothing. And I really did dig that. You know, it's an interesting thing to capture from the beginning of a book all the way to the end, even when all sorts of crazy shit is happening to her. It still feels colorless and quiet. On an absolutely totally different note, there is a whole bunch of not colorless and not quiet books that we picked up. A nice copy of Clive Barker's Cabal. We have a copy of it in French, I believe. But hey, this is neat. I was really like a hardly used, gently used copy. It's like a dollar, so why not add it to the Clive Barker collection, a nice vintage paperback. And a super classic, The Castle of Otranto by Horace Walpole, a bleeding statue, a praying skeleton, a castle of horror, it says. And this little pink edition is from Collier Books, who I've not heard of. That must be a very old paperback pocketbook company from New York from back in the day, because this is extremely old and cute and hardly used at all. And who can go wrong for a dollar? I mean, Stephen King, The Dark Tower. This is really thick. I have the first Dark Tower book, and it's like, it's a big trade copy. So it's, the book itself is bigger, but it doesn't feel as thick. Now this, the drawing of the three is huge. I didn't realize what a tome it was. And I've read this whole series up to The Wolves of the Cala. I haven't read that book, but that or Song of Susanna. I read Song of Susanna. I don't remember which comes first in that order, but yeah. Kind of a lame cover with three doors. I mean, yeah, come on. Could be way more interesting looking than that. I don't know what sort of like weird trailer house cut the cover of this book, but yeah, it's not doing it for me at all. But hey, I get to reread it along with Jason and Sin. And the weirdest find, The Night Church. And like, if you, like me, have followed Whitley Strieber and are interested in his ideas as far as aliens, that's the most I know of the man. I've not read fiction by Whitley Strieber. Some people would count Communion as fiction. I don't. I think that that absolutely happened for the most part, like what parts of it that he talks about. But yeah, this appears to be signed, but it's signed over the sticker. So I'm not really sure what's going on here. Yeah, it says Truro, 1986, from Ottawa, 1986. So I think that's the dates that somebody read it, but it looks like a Whitley Strieber signature in it. Very, very strange. Not really sure what's going on there, but it's in good condition. You know, it's probably a book club copy, but I really like the looks of it and I'll have a fun time reading it. And that's not all. I usually have a hard time finding like contemporary horror at the Mammoth book sale because it is a library book sale and there's not like a lot of like extreme horror to be found that I really like. But an Adam Neville book, Under a Watchful Eye, I've not read it. I'm very interested in it. And it was like a brand new copy for very inexpensive. I think that these are $2 when it's these newer editions. I also got a nice David Moody book. None of the Hater series that I really love so much, but I always wanted to check out Autumn, which he wrote after that series or during the middle of the end of it, well after Dog Blood and Hater. I really enjoyed those books and maybe I'll like this too. I like David Moody and I like hearing him talk about writing, so I'll read Autumn. In the autumn, probably. And last but not least, Disappearance at Devil's Rock by Paul Tremblay. There's been a lot of back and forth. I guess people love him or hate him lately, and I don't know why. He's an okay writer. I enjoy his work. I liked Head Full of Ghosts. There's a lot of back and forth about Head Full of Ghosts still to this day, and a lot of his other stuff hasn't really gotten read. So I want to read this because for whatever reason, it reminds me a lot of The Picnic at Hanging Rock, and I think that was an influence here. I'll have to read it. And I'll find out. So maybe this will be a good summer read. We'll find out. In the meantime, I do want to pick up a Stephen King book, the new one, and maybe this will suffice in the meantime. So that is it for stuff that I have picked up recently. And I will be talking about The Haunting of Velkwood by Gwendolyn Keist, Small Town Horror by Ronald Malfi, and talking about that really cool Boris Karloff anthology to show off the images inside. If you read any of these books, I know there's like a big mix of old and new here, but I'm very interested if people have enjoyed the newer books I've talked about and the Paul Tremblay book too, as well as the old ones. So yeah, if there's anything here that piqued your interest that you're going to go and pick up, let me know as well. Thank you very much for watching and have an ooky spooky day.